the rapture is a belief that Jesus Christ will return initially for the church. He will come not quite to earth, he will come and then the church will be taken up to meet him. That's the view of the rapture. That is particularly prominent in a system of theology, a system of eschatology called premillennial dispensationalism. The problem is, though, you actually end up with effectively two second comings. You get Jesus coming the first time for the church to rapture them away, and then after a period of tribulation, he comes again for the second time. This is the second part of the second coming, you know, second coming 2.B, where he comes with the church, largely in judgment to rescue those who also became believers during a great period of tribulation. Problem is, I don't think the New Testament, and certainly its more deliberate eschatological discourses or any of the narratives or the instruction of Jesus or what we find in the book of Revelation, I don't think it splits up the second coming of Jesus along those lines. I think the second coming of Jesus is more singular, more unitary, more comprehensive and definitive. So I'd be more inclined to say that there is a period of tribulation or trial that comes upon the world where there's apostasy and there's persecution, the sort of things spoken about in 1 Thessalonians. And then at the end of that, after a period of tribulation, Christ returns. And it's not that the church is raptured to go meet him, but rather he returns definitively, where he has, as Paul says, he then hands over the kingdom to the Father. And this is the moment, I like to say, where Jesus will be by might what he is by right, Lord of all.